In this operation, we're going to apply a silicone gasketing adhesive to the front plate of the speaker. This adhesive is used not so much to bond the front plate to the basket as it is to prevent metal-to-metal vibrations between the plate and the basket. After the silicone is applied to the front plate is then staked to the basket using the four nubs on the front plate. Our next step is assembling the magnet assembly. The first step is applying a primer to the T-yoke, which will help to accelerate the adhesive that bonds the magnet and the T-yoke. The adhesive that we use is an anaerobic structural acrylic that cures very, very quickly and forms a very durable bond between the T-yoke and the magnet. The magnet is set in place and a centering fixture that centers the magnet and the T-pole is attached. Next, we remove the magnet to yoke centering bushing and apply the same adhesive to the magnet and basket top plate assembly. We use the primer to accelerate the process, and we use the structural acrylic on top of that. This adhesive sets up and cures in about 30 seconds. A bushing is installed that will precisely align the T-yoke pole and the basket front plate. Now that the magnet assembly adhesive is cured, we're going to remove the centering bushing and we're going to install the voice coil. The voice coil has been placed over a precise plastic centering gauge, which not only centers the coil concentrically in the magnetic field, but also sets the windings properly relative to the magnetic field. Next, we apply a bead of adhesive to the basket that will be used to anchor the spider to the basket. The adhesive that we use in this operation is a soft, water-soluble adhesive that bonds to both painted steel and to treated cloth equally well. Our next step is bonding the voice coil to the spider. In this bond, we use a rubber toughened high temperature cyanoacrylate. Cyanoacrylates are better known as superglues. They're durable, they're temperature resistant, and they cure very, very quickly. We apply an activator to accelerate the curing time. Our next step is bonding the cone to the basket. In this operation, we apply the water-soluble adhesive that we used to bond the spider to the basket. It bonds the cone, which is a polyether foam, to the painted steel basket. The cone is installed so that the eyelets in the cone line up with the voice coil leads and also the terminal strip mounting on the basket. A second bead of adhesive is applied to the top of the cone surround that will be used to bond the gasket to the cone. In this step, we're going to bond the voice coil to the cone. We use the same rubber toughened high temperature cyanoacrylate to make the bond, and then we activate it to accelerate the curing time. Like all adhesives that are applied to a speaker, the correct location and the correct amount is critical for a speaker to operate properly. Our next step is installing the tinsel wire into the speaker and connecting the wire between the terminal strip on the basket and the eyelets on the cone. First, we thread the tinsel wire through the eyelets on the cone, and then using a tweezer, we thread that through a hole in the terminal strip. There's two wires in a single coil loudspeaker, so we thread the two tinsels through those. Next, we're going to solder the tinsel wire to the terminal strip. Soldering in this application is challenging because the wire contains a Kevlar or cotton thread, so we need enough heat for the solder to flow evenly, but not so much heat that we burn the thread and the fiber. Next, we're going to wrap the voice coil wire around the eyelets of the cone to make a mechanical connection between the voice coil and the tinsel leads. We put a small form in the wire as a strain relief so that as the cone is operating, the wire does not see any tension. Next, we solder the tensile wire and voice coil wire at the cone eyelet. Again, this is a challenging operation with needing enough heat for the solder to flow, but not too much to burn either the tensile lead or the paper cone. The last part of this step is trimming off the excess tensile lead, both from the terminal strip and also on top of the cone and the cone eyelets. The last part to install into the speaker is the dust cap. First, we remove the voice coil centering gauge. Next, we apply a soft, flexible vinyl adhesive over the voice coil wires and eyelet areas. This prevents the wires from buzzing and also makes sure that they're supported with adhesive and don't break during operation. Next, we apply the adhesive to the cone so that we can install the dust cap. Once the dust cap is applied, the speaker assembly is finished. The adhesives are allowed to cure prior to moving to magnetization and final testing. As you can see, it's not magnetized. We put it into a capacitor discharge magnetizer. The charging time is very, very quick. And when the speaker comes out, it's fully charged.